Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Later on, the same day that SpaceX launched the Crew 5 mission, they also launched the Starlink mission. The booster which launched this mission, B1071, then landed successfully for the fifth time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing burn.
So there we can see the landing burn has begun. Rushing through the clouds, and there's the drone ship.
Stage 2 FTS has saved. Landing leg deploy.
And there you can see on
stage
your screen.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
And heard there with the call out, Falcon 9 has successfully landing, marking the 145th landing of an Orbital class rocket, our 45th launch of 2022.
Connect. SpaceX posted a tweet about this launch saying deployment of 52 Starlink satellites confirmed, completing SpaceX's second launch in approximately 7 hours. In addition to that launch, SpaceX was planning another launch the following day, but that was aborted. It was then moved to yesterday when SpaceX successfully launched the Galaxy 33 and 34 satellites.
2, 1, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go Falcon, go Intelsat Galaxy 33 and 34.
Falcon 9, pitching downrange.
The booster which launched this mission, B1060, then landed successfully for the 14th time, becoming the second booster to do so.
Stage 1 landing burn.
Landing burn startup.
Engine cutoff.
You just heard the call out there for second engine cutoff on the second stage.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing is confirmed.
Awesome. Successful landing on our drone ship about 600 kilometers off the coast of Florida. You also heard in there the second engine cutoff on our second stage. So just handling them in order here. 146th recovery for an orbital class rocket, including first stage landings for Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy.
The Falcon 9 launch abort was an auto abort by the rocket itself, and Musk posted information about the reason. He said, "Tiny helium leak just barely triggered abort, but we take no risks with customer satellites. Standing down to investigate." Eric Berger posted an interesting tweet about the last launch we just saw. He said, SpaceX launched its 180th Falcon 9 rocket tonight and 46th booster of the year for a cadence of one flight every 6.1 days. This first stage was making its 14th flight and was a purely commercial mission. The customer received no discount for an aged booster. Reuse is real. Coming up this week, we can hopefully expect yet another Falcon 9 launch. As you can see on the SpaceX Fans website, the launch of Hotbird 13F is scheduled to lift off on Thursday 13th at 3:25 a.m. UTC or Wednesday 12th at 11:25 p.m. EDT. I want to share this cool video that Elon Musk posted on Twitter from a Starlink satellite of Earth and other Starlinks. Also, what's cool is you can see the Falcon 9 second stage in the top right performing a deorbit burn. There was an article posted related to Starlink and the next generation satellites. It says, to build its second generation Starlink network, SpaceX is aiming to conduct frequent rocket launches weekly to start, but potentially ramping up to once every few days. SpaceX mentioned the plan in a Tuesday FCC filing about the second generation constellation, which will span nearly 30,000 satellites. There was some extremely exciting Falcon Heavy related news posted. It feels like forever since there's been a Falcon Heavy launch, but we can hopefully expect to see another very soon. This article says more than 3 years after SpaceX's Falcon Heavy rocket last blazed a path into orbit, the 28-engine launcher is finally set to fly again as soon as October 28 from Kennedy Space Center in Florida on a long-delayed national security mission for the US Space Force, a military spokesperson said. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. Work on upgrading the orbital launch mount has been continuing. The chopstick catching arms were seen being tested. The work behind the megabay has been continuing. Inside the megabay there is a nose cone hooked up to a crane. There is an extension being added to the side of Star Factory. Here's a view of barrel sections being worked on inside Star Factory. Here's a view of a ship aft dome waiting outside for sleeving. Crews were seen working to repair Ship 24's heat shield tiles. Work on the Ship 25 prototype is continuing in the high bay. The Booster 7 prototype was rolled out after robustness upgrades for hopefully the last time before launch. Booster 7 was also moved inside the chopsticks to be lifted onto the orbital launch mount. Taking a look at the road and beach closures for possible testing, there are some dates this coming week. There are possible closures scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 10th, Tuesday 11th and Wednesday 12th. Finally, to finish up today's video, we have an updated Starbase production diagram to take a look at thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, I have to say thank you to Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.